In this video, we will talk about the bones of the face region. So this is our third category. So bones of face region. There are total 14 bones in our face region. So let us see these bones where they are located and let us write down their numbers. The first bone that we are talking of are nasal bones. They are known as nasals. Nasals or nasal bone. Now, where exactly these nasal bones are present? This nose of ours has a hard part here, which we call the nose bridge. So, this part is made up of two such bones, which are placed at an angle, and these are the nasal bones. So, nasal bones, and they are two in number. This is a paired one. So, one on one side and the other one on the other side. Between these two nasal bones, like when these two nasal bones are placed like this, between this there is a single small bone which is called the vomer. So this vomer is actually just one in number and it is between the two nasal bones. The third bone is known as zygomatic or cheekbone. It runs from here and goes up till this part. So our cheekbone, this bone which is running, this is zygomatic or cheekbones. Again, they are two in number. So one on this side of our face and the other one on the other side. The fourth one, these bones are inside our nasal chamber. So we cannot see it from outside or we cannot pinpoint that position. So in the nasal chamber, there are again paired, one in one chamber, the other one is in the other chamber. These bones are known as conchi or inferior turbinal. Inferior turbinal or conchi. Two in number. And if you're able to recall that in our nasal chamber, there are certain folds which are known as superior concha, inferior concha, lateral concha. These are folds. And these folds are to increase the surface area for one, the detection of smell and the function of nose specifically. And to support that fold of the skin or the membrane, this bone is present. So these are also paired structure, two in number. The next one, lacrimal bones. These bones support lacrimal gland. So in our orbit region, here is the lacrimal gland. So if this is the lacrimal gland, the part of the orbit just above it has a bone to support it. So they are called lacrimal bones. And one on each side. So one on in one orbit and the other is on the other side. So they are also paired bones. The next category or the next bone which we have in our facial region are known as palatine bones. In our buccal cavity, the roof we can say, the roof of the buccal cavity or the structure which separates our nasal chamber and the buccal cavity is known as palate. The anterior part of our palate is bony and these are bones which we are talking about, they are called palatine bones and they are two in number. So these bones are like this. They separate the nasal chamber from the buccal cavity or we say they make the roof of the buccal cavity. So again, two in number. Then let us come to the upper jaw, that is maxillae. So maxillae or maxilla, again two in number. So up till now, how many bones have we talked of? We have talked of two nasals which make this nose bridge. There is a bone in between these two nasals which is the vomer. These two cheekbones which are zygomatic. Then the lacrimal. Okay, we have taken inferior conchi first. In the nasal chamber are present these conchi. Then lacrimal. Then palatine on the palate, but anterior part, posterior part of our palate is cartilaginous. Maxilla. Now let us come to this lower jaw. This is mandible. So eighth is mandible. And mandible is single. Let us add this to 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13 and 14. So this gives us all 14 bones of our face region. The part which we see in the front, which we call face, these are the bones which are there. One quick recap of where these bones are and why they have been given these names. Nasal, they make the nose bridge. They are two bones like this, angular place. So this is the part where we have nasal. One on this side, one here. Between the nasal, there is a thin bone which is in between. And that bone is actually in the septum. The septum which separates the nose into two compartments. That septum has a little bone in it. So that is the vomer. Zygomatic, that is our cheekbone. So one here, one on the other side. Inferior terminal, which is in our nasal chamber. So one on this side, one on the other side. Lacrimal, this is in the orbit part. It supports the lacrimal or the tear gland. So one is on this side, the other one comes here in the orbit region. Palatine, this is in the palate part, anterior part. And palate makes the roof of the buccal cavity. So these two bones are placed like this in the palate region. So these are palatine. Upper jaw is made up of two bones, one half and the other half. So these are two maxillae. And lower jaw is made up of only one bone, that is the mandible. So these 14 bones are in our face region. And last bone which is there in this skull part of the axial skeleton is known as hyoid bone, or it is also known as tongue bone. It is present just beneath the tongue in this lower jaw part, that is in the mandible. It is fitted like this at the bottom, at the base of the tongue. The bone has three main parts. There is this body part and there are two such projections. One longer projection, one smaller projection. So this is known as the body. These smaller projections are known as the lesser cornu, and the bigger ones are known as greater cornu. And this bone provides attachment site for the tongue muscles. So this is hyoid. This is one in number. So let us total all the bones of our skull region. Cranium has 8 bones. We have seen all those 8 using the model also. 1 frontal, 2 parietal, 2 temporal, 1 occipital, 1 sphenoid and 1 ethmoid. Then auditory, 3 in each middle ear. Facial bones, these 14 facial bones and 1 hyoid. So the total is 14 plus 6 is 20. Plus 8, 28 and 129. So our skull region of the axial skeleton is made up of 29 bones, and we divide the skull complete part into 4 different categories. Cranial bones, then the auditory bones, then bones of the face region and hyoid or the tongue bone. So in our axial skeleton, we are done with the first part, that is skull. In the next part, we will talk about the vertebrae and then different types of vertebrae and the entire vertebral.